you know, the source of the problems, because anybody could just blame it on some rich person who's hoarding money and discriminating
people
against
them.
People
love that. They love doing that.
And then just say, oh, the solution. See, if you blame the problems on some rich person, well, the solution is easy. Just take his money, right? Have the government come in and redistribute the wealth, which is another word for steal. Take money from somebody who earned it and give it to somebody who didn't. But if you actually take a little bit of time and use your head instead of your heart, your feelings, you'll learn that that the source of the problems is government interference in the economy, and that the protest should be directed at government, at their regulations and their subsidies and their taxes and all the things that government does to stifle economic growth and deny opportunities to people.
I think there would be a really funny documentary if you could do like a documentary on the last occupier, like the last person to occupy Wall Street, because there had to be like stragglers, right? It eventually must have gotten to the point where there was like 30 people left, 20 people left, and one guy. No, fuck these people, man.
Well, they started occupying different areas, right? Because it caught on and it was all over the world. They were occupying here and occupying there.
And they were setting up camps, right? They were essentially living there.
Yeah. And who knows what else they were doing there. But now the Occupy More movement kind of morphed into the Bernie Sanders movement, right? Because that's where all those guys are now. They were volunteering for the Sanders campaign. And socialism is really kind of going mainstream now because they put the word Democrat in front of it.
Yes.
As if somehow that changes the meaning, right? Well, I'm not a socialist. I'm a democratic socialist, meaning I want to vote for socialism as opposed to just have, an armed revolution. But the end is still the same, right? It's still socialism, and it doesn't work.
Yeah, I was watching an interview with Tucker Carlson and some guy who's a professor at Harvard, and he said, "I'll give you the last word." The guy said, "Socialism's going to win." And he made the piece. I'm like, "What is that? What does that even mean? Socialism is going to win. What does that mean? And what is socialism?"
Well, it could win at the polls. That's the problem. It's very intoxicating to people who don't know any better.
Right.
And the interesting thing
about people, they have too much money.
Yeah. The interesting thing about socialism is that no matter how many times it fails, people expect it to succeed, right? That's the definition of insanity, right? Doing something over and over again and expecting a different result. Well, the socialists always expect a different result from doing something that has never succeeded in the past.
So socialism by definition is one thing, but by the emotional reaction that people have is kind of another thing. The emotional reaction is there's rich people that are a real problem. They're hoarding. They're greedy. I'm not concerned with money. I'm concerned with people and community and feelings and health and welfare and education. And all that money, we should take it from those rich people and we should funnel it into education and community. And they say all these words that make people feel good. Like, we're not about money either.
Yeah,
and
it's all about feeling good. That's what the liberals are about. It's about, feeling that they're better than everybody else because they're higher up on this moral pedestal because they don't care about money. They just care about, people and, but when you talk about rich people, they don't hoard money. I mean, the way you get rich is not by hoarding. The way you get rich is by trying to figure out what problems people have that you can solve, right? Whether it's inventing something that makes their lives better or providing a service that makes their lives better, because the customers are in charge, individuals, right? That's what's going to allocate wealth. It's if somebody is better than somebody else at satisfying the desires that people have, right? If I can come up with something that you like, that you want to buy, that's cheaper and better than what somebody else has come up with, then you're going to buy from me. And so the person who ends up with the most money is the person who's satisfied the most desires, the most needs in the most efficient way possible. And that's what's benefiting society. I mean, it's great to have charity, and I'm all for private charity. But if you look at the wealthiest men in history, even though they've been incredible philanthropers and they've given away a lot of money, they helped a lot more people amassing their fortunes than gifting away what they made. It was the businesses that they created, the products that they invented, the services that they provided, and the employment, right, that was all a function of their creating their wealth. That's what did a lot more to help society than simply giving away some of the money that they earned.
Have you ever had a debate with a democratic socialist?
Well, I mean, most Democrats are socialists. They just don't know it, or they don't want to admit it. And a lot of people don't even understand what socialism is, because, you'll have the left, they'll always consider somebody, like even Donald Trump, they'll say, oh, he's a fascist, right? They don't even realize that fascism is part of socialism. Socialism is a broad concept that includes things like communism and fascism. So if you're a communist, you are a socialist. But it doesn't mean that if you're a socialist, you're a communist, because you could be a fascist. You could be for a lot of things. But fascism is a form of socialism where the government doesn't just steal all the property. Like the communists want to nationalize everything and take legal ownership of the means of production, right? The government just owns all the capital. Under fascism, the government is a little bit smarter. They realize that people will work harder if they think they're working for themselves. So the fascist doesn't want to nationalize businesses. They just want to control it through regulation and taxes. And that's pretty much what the Democrats want to do. They want to control everything by taxing it heavily and regulating it. And that's an important aspect of fascism. I mean, a lot of people associate fascism with racism just because the Nazis were racist. But you don't have to be racist. I mean, fascism started in Italy, and that there wasn't any racism there. And if you go back to the Nazi Party, it's the National Socialist Party of Germany. That's what the Nazis are. It's socialists. So fascism is a form of socialism. That's why the communists and the fascists, you know, argue so much, because they're fighting over the same turf. It's which brand of socialism is better, fascism or communism. But they're not at opposite ends of the political spectrum. They're on the same end.